Hi guys, in this tutorial we are going to see how to push our local repository changes to the remote repository. So in my previous video we already covered the setup of local repository and the staging index, and we commit the changes to the local repository. Okay, so now to move the changes from local to remote, we need to create a remote repository first. So let me create a repository. Click on new. I'm creating a repository called Git demo. If you want, you can add a description. I'm adding Git example and it is public. If you want, you can initialize the repository with readme so that you can add your description, and dot git ignore none, and license is also none. If you want, you can specify any. So now let's create a repository. Okay, we created a remote repository in our GitHub. Okay, and we have our local repository git demo. Let's cross verify once. This piece of code we wrote in the previous tutorial, same we want to push to the remote. Okay, so now let's go to the project directory. Right click here, open git bash here. Okay, so now from command we need to set our remote repository from local to remote. To set our remote repository, you can check here or push an existing repository from the command line. Okay, existing local repository we are going to push to the remote through the command line. Now let's copy this. Git remote add origin, and this is my repository in remote which we created. Okay, now we set the origin to our remote repository. Now let's push the changes now. So for that, type git push username flag to origin master. Currently we are working on master branch as we didn't create any sub branch. Okay, okay, now our local changes move to the remote. So now let's check in our GitHub. Let's refresh this page. Okay, you can check whatever we have in our local, it came to the remote one. Okay, now hope you get some idea about the local and remote repository. Now let's check the diagram which we already covered. Distributed version control, previously we are here and we move the code to local repository. Now we push our code to the this remote repository. Okay, now let's do one thing. Let's change again something in our working copy and we'll send it to local. From local again we are going to push into the remote repository. Okay, so go to our workspace. Suppose I got some change request, so that we should not hard code the value. So for that, let's create a class called constant. Declare a field public static data type. Java Techie, it is a string. Okay, now instead of hard code in class we can directly refer to the constant one. Okay, and we removed the SOPLN statement and we removed this comment as well. Okay, now we add one file, that is the constant file, and we did some changes in our, we did some changes in our app.java class. Okay, now we'll push those changes to the local. From local we'll check and we'll push those to the remote one. So now check the git status. You can check two file modified, app.java target, this is the dot class. Okay, so now let's add all, type git add. You can check constant class we added and this one is the modified. So let me add all. If you want to add one, then just copy this which you want to add, then you can specify in this double quote. Okay, but I am going to add all. That's why give the dot. Let me clear the console. Now check git status, all are showing modified. Okay, now let me commit those changes to my local repository. So for that type git commit, give some message, added constant class and change in app.java. Okay, now I committed to my local repository, so these changes will not reflect to our remote repository. So let's check once. Let me refresh this, go to the src, go to the Java. You can check in remote still the comment and this hardcode value is there. Okay, so now we did the changes and we push it to our local repository. It is not available in remote. So to available those changes in remote, to reflect those, we need to type git push. As you are in current branch master, you can type git push, but better to mention the origin as well. Okay, now our changes move to the remote repository. So let's go to the GitHub, let's refresh this page. You can check constant class added, go to the git demo. There is two class, constant and app.java. In app.java we remove the SOPLN statement and we remove the comment. Okay, so this is how we can push our changes from local to the remote repository. You can check the comment which I added, added constant class and change in app.java to contributor. Okay, so that's it about this particular video. This video I just covered the local changes to the remote, how we can push, and in my next video I will show you how to clone, or we can say how to check out the code from remote to the local, and how we can take the update using git pull. Okay, so if anyone have any doubt, you can add a comment, and those who not subscribed yet, please go ahead and subscribe it. Thanks for watching this video.